Reagan. Today I'm back doing a unboxing for my Cinemate 15 Bose system. I bought this from Best Buy. It was on sale for $4.99. This is Bose, I guess, lower model when it comes to home cinema. It's their version of a soundbar and subwoofer. I'm going to be comparing this to the existing surround sound that I have, which is a Samsung surround sound, so 5.1. Later on, you'll hear the difference, although I know over the camera phone, you don't really get to hear it, but at least you'll hear my opinion on the two. I'm going to be connecting this to my Xbox One, which is going to be playing off of my Epson 1080p projector. So let's get started. I can tell you that this is not wireless. And the inputs are digital audio and analog audio. Bose is known pretty much for their sound, and which is also why I look forward to hearing what this would sound like. So let's get it open, and then we'll try to see what it sounds like once we get it together. I was pretty happy with the Samsung surround sound that I purchased recently, but I figured, let me see what this one sounds like. I actually paid $224 for my Samsung. It was an open box. Normally it's $299 on sale. Let's see, first box here. This is the actual sound bar. Okay. It's actually attached. Comes with your analog cables. So on the back here, we have our optical connection, our coaxial, and our analogs, left and right here. These look like vents for the speakers. On the flip side here, I do see two speakers up front. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, but they're actually facing diagonal, like a wave on a slant. They're not facing straight. And it looks like we have speakers on the sides as well. Okay, very good, very, very nice looking, very aesthetically pleasing. Okay, we have our manual. These have some rubber feet. Open it up. We have our batteries. We have our rubber feet here. Maybe we'll go under the subwoofer. It looks like they're very thick. Stop vibrating. And this is our remote device codes to set the remote. And we have our Cinemate 15 manual. Don't forget a manual. And we got another box here on the side. Okay. First, we have our optical cable. It did come with the cable, which is very cool. Love when things come ready to play. We have our analog connection. And this is our power cord. Okay, and on the right here, we have our Bose remote. So we have a lot of functions on here. Might actually use this to connect to everything and just set everything up on this one remote instead of having four different remotes. Okay, and last but not least, we have our subwoofer. I'm gonna go ahead and flip this over. Pretty heavy. Samsung subwoofer that I have is very light. I've always felt like all the Samsung sounds that are out now are made very cheaply. You get some decent sound, but nothing like the old stuff. Okay, so this is the sub. This is the back portion of it. We have a knob. Well, we have the power cable. We have our connectors here. And we have a bass knob. You can adjust the bass level on this particular model. I have no HDMI connection here. So, you know, you're very limited. But depending on what your use is for, I think that the sound is going to be worth it. If you want something that has the HDMI cables, you're going to have to go up a step up on this model. And that model is about $1,000 right now. This is the side angle. And here is the front. Okay, so, and this is what you're looking at here as far as everything that came in the box. Okay, you have your subwoofer, universal remote, you have your power cable, audio cables, and optical cable, rubber feet, two AA batteries, your manuals, and the front sound bar. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this thing together. I'm gonna give you a little bit of demo. We'll decide what movie when we come back. Stay tuned. Took about 10 minutes to set this up. Two cords plug into the back of the subwoofer and you plug it in, and that's pretty much it. Very easy to set up. So I'm going to be doing finishing the review with the Bose 15 Cinemate, but I'm also going to be comparing it to the Samsung that I purchased recently, which also comes with a 3D Blu-ray player. I don't really use this Blu-ray player at all. I usually play everything through my Xbox. So, the Samsung goes for $299. The Bose goes for $499 on sale. Normally it's $599. Alright, so the Samsung has surround sound speakers, so I have a left, a right, the center channel, a subwoofer. And that's the Bose subwoofer, so you can kind of see the huge difference there. Okay, and here on the back side, I have my two satellite surround speakers playing through my projector. Okay, so we're going to start off playing a little bit of music so you can hear the difference. Okay, I am going to be playing the music through my iPhone 6 Plus. Wirelessly through the Samsung, and then I'm going to switch over to the Bose, which is connected to the aux auxiliary cable. Okay, so again, this is the Samsung.
Again.
this in, it's gonna be the Bose. Okay, so that is the audio demo. Just to tell you a little bit about, because I know you're not going to hear it very clearly over this phone, but the Samsung sounds great, actually, but the Bose sounds so much clearer, and the quality is, obviously it's Bose, you're going to get better quality sound from it, but the Samsung does stand up. The only thing that I right now dislike about the Bose is that it's not wireless, so I have to connect with the wire. Samsung has a lot more features with it, but if you're willing to sacrifice features over quality, that is your decision. Me personally, I like the crisp sound and the heavy bass that comes out of the Bose. The bass is actually 80 times to 90 times better than what's coming out of the Samsung. And you know, Bose is known for their acoustic mass. So I'm gonna go ahead and play a movie so that we can hear the difference with the movie. See if you can tell. I'm gonna be playing Spider-Man, Spider-Man 3 on Blu-ray, playing through my Xbox. So we'll cut out, we'll come back so you can see, or you can hear what it sounds like. Thanks. Okay, so this is Spider-Man 3 on the screen. We're going to start off with the Samsung, and then we're going to switch to the Bose. I'll try to let you know because it's going to be a little bit loud. If you can hear me good, if not, you'll maybe hear the difference between the switch. So this is the Samsung.
Not Mary Jane!
Switching to the Bose. Spider-Man. Let's switch back. back to the Samsung one more time.
Just in the nick of time.
A couple minutes ago wouldn't have been so bad either.
What are you gonna do?
I may need some help over here. I'm a little busy right now. Come here, Ed!
Okay, gonna switch back to the Bose last time. The end of the test. Both surround sounds did very well. I think you may have been able to hear that the Bose has a deeper bass to it. It gives you that movie theater type effect. The Samsung has some decent bass, but it's nowhere next to the Bose. I guess it all comes down to how much you would spend. The Samsung was $299, the Bose was $499. So you're paying a little bit more. Now the Samsung does have a lot more features. It comes with a Blu-ray player, a 3D Blu-ray player at that, FM radio is included on that. And you have six speakers for that surround sound. The Bose is just two pieces, but it does a great job of creating that true surround sound without having all the other speakers. If you do not have a Blu-ray player or an Xbox One, I would say to go with the Samsung because you're getting more for the money. But if you're looking for more quality and you're really into the bass, then definitely go with the Bose. Honestly, it was just, it's a really hard choice to decide between the two because of the money. I think if the Bose was $100 cheaper, it'd be no competition. I would just go with the Bose because I don't need all that extra stuff when it comes to the Blu-ray player or anything like that. The plus with the Samsung is that it is wireless to connect to your phone, so if you want to play music, you can do that. The Bose, you have to use an analog connection. My choice, I'm going to probably end up staying with the Bose because I am a bass person. And I like, you know, deep bass. If you're not a bass person and you're okay with, you know, mid bass, then that's fine. I would go to Samsung. If not, then the Bose. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. I'm going to list the model numbers in the description below. Hit that like button if it was helpful. And subscribe. I have a lot more videos coming out, especially gameplay videos. Thanks.